Do you know why levodopa and carbidopa are given together when treating Parkinsonism? Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we will see benefits of combining levodopa and carbidopa. Let's get started. This is brain. This is blood-brain barrier, and this patient is having Parkinsonism. Problem in Parkinsonism is decreased dopamine activity in basal ganglia. When you give levodopa to the patient, it enters into the brain. Here, it gets converted into dopamine, which restores dopamine activity to some extent. Now, problem here is this peripheral dopa decarboxylase enzyme. It converts most of the levodopa into dopamine in periphery. This dopamine cannot cross blood-brain barrier. So, this portion does not contribute in anti-Parkinsonian action. Moreover, it produces side effects. For example, it stimulates dopamine receptor in chemoreceptor trigger zone and causes vomiting. Cardiac toxicity is also a concern. These are the problems with giving levodopa alone. Now let's bring in carbidopa. It inhibits peripheral dopa decarboxylase. So no dopamine is produced in periphery. This means no peripheral side effects. Also, now more dopamine can enter into the brain, which gives better results to patient. So that was the detail. Short answer is levodopa plus carbidopa is equal to improved anti-Parkinsonian effect and decreased peripheral side effects of levodopa. That's it friends for this video. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends too. Let me know in comments which drug combination video you want to see next. Also check out other videos on drug combination. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.